get on up for the Jason Decanio Show, starring your host, Jason Decanio.
Yes, indeed. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's the Jason Decanio Show from the WJDC studios in Oviedo, Florida, for episode number 185 on this October 16, 2011. And tonight, 3 hours. This is it, folks. The biggest interview of my career and of my special guest's career. And tonight is also a video requesting video recording of this whole show. For the next 3 hours, the Nick Jones interview. Right now I have some of his music playing. This is called Means to a Groove. You're going to hear that plus a little bit more until Nick is ready to be set up here. And then for that big interview. So when we come back, more of Nick Jones right after this. Right there, that was What's Next, and before that we heard Means to a Groove. Well, I am really excited tonight because in the studio I have the man who I've been talking to for the past 2.5 months, the man I have been telling you about for the last week and a half. Here he is right now, Mr. Instrumentalist, Nick Jones. Good evening, how are ya?
Hey, I'm pretty good, my man. How about yourself?
I am ecstatic that you are here, and we have video today. This is the first time I have video. Wow.
Video in the house in the Jason Decanio Show.
That's right. And I'll tell you, this is an exciting weekend because this is the first of hopefully many interviews with us, with you here at the studio.
You bet.
So, what's the, because we're going to be talking here, we got the next 3 hours pretty much. Mm-hmm. This is all you. This is, you know, unfortunately, it's unfortunate we can't get you to play tonight because of the configurations of that, but.
Yeah, we had a little technical deal, but it's all good. At least we got the music going, and we got the wonderful voice of Jason Decanio, and we got the Jason Decanio's fans,
that's
listeners,
right. Yep.
And we got my supporters in the house as well. I know you're out there.
Oh, yes, indeed. And this show is, of course, our regular recording. This is episode 185, so this is a regular scheduled broadcast show tonight with live audio feed, and it will be recorded and in the archives for later playback at your leisure time. That might, it's going to be interesting to get that. There you go. All right.
Yeah, we'll make it work, man. We'll make it work.
Okay. Well, you see how deep I'm, see, I got the phone here, and I can go right up to the mic, and boom, there you go. So, all right, if you're ready to go here, let's go ahead and talk to you and get you underway here. So, tell us about yourself.
Well, I'm obviously a composer. Mm-hmm. I'm also a news reporter. We'll get to that in a bit.
Yep.
I just have a love for just music, you know, sound. Blends of sounds together. You know, people always ask me, well, what kind of music do you play? Well, I tell them whatever sounds good. So, I don't really like to put myself in a box, a jazz musician, a funk, a hip-hop. You know, I try to do all of it because I have a love for music, man.
Mm-hmm.
So, I've been playing keyboards, I guess, about since the age of 10. I won't tell you how long that is, because I don't want you doing any math out there, you know what I'm saying?
There you go. That's cool. So, did you know at the age of 10 that this is where your dream was to eventually take you?
Well, actually, earlier than that, mm-hmm. my dad bought me a guitar. He uh-huh. bought me a harmonica. So, I messed around with that a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Went over to a cousin's house, and he had a little toy keyboard, and I messed around with that. I was hooked.
Wow.
But I still appreciate all the other instruments, you know, the sounds of the instruments. That's why when you listen to my music, I've spent my whole life trying to emulate the sounds of actual instruments, like guitar, anything from guitar, pan flutes, drums.
Mm-hmm.
So if you look at my video and you see me, you know, it's not just to push a button. I'm actually putting my heart into, you know, trying to make it sound great.
Right. That's great. That's fun. Now, are you from Texas originally, or where are you originally from?
I was born in Wichita, Kansas.
Wichita, Kansas.
Wasn't there long enough to know what it looks like. I've raised in Texas. Hook 'em horns.
Right. Hook 'em horns, all right. And then when did you make the move over to Texas? Or did you, when did you eventually settle down in Texas?
The move was made for me because I've been in Texas since I was like 2 years old.
Okay, so your parents decided that Texas is where we're going to make the roots.
Yeah, we packed up and headed on to Texas. I drove.
There you go. And did you, were you always involved with music all through your childhood?
My dad was a guitarist. You know, we used to sit around, and play music with him. Mm-hmm. You know, he was into like Jimmy Reed, Lightning Hopkins, you know, old music like that.
Right.
My mother is a fantastic singer. She sings a lot of gospel songs. She was into Mahalia Jackson a lot. So Mahalia Jackson on one side and Lightning Hopkins on the other side. What can I say? So I guess from early on, I learned to appreciate all forms of music.
There you go.
As long as it sounds good and as long as there is some proficiency in what you're doing. Mm-hmm. As long as you are good at your instrument, it doesn't matter what you're playing.
Yeah. But is this one instrument that you would hold dear to, and is that the guitar or would that be the piano or?
Well, right now my sound, I like to call it the hybrid guitar. Mm-hmm. It looks like a keyboard and it sounds like a guitar.
So you kind of labeled it the hybrid. It's like the hybrid car almost.
Yeah.
Like, there you go. Very nice. Who was your biggest influence in school, teacher-wise?
You got my biggest influence in school. Well, actually, school itself, the school of life. You know, different, you know, anywhere from math to science to just all of the subjects.
Right.
You know, I really wouldn't say in particular one teacher, because they all had a part in shaping who I am.
Right, exactly.
So there's a little bit of my Spanish teacher in me, there's a little bit of even my old football coaches and all that stuff. You know, instilled in the toughness and the never giving up attitude.
Right. How good of a football player were you?
Well, I wasn't too bad.
Right.
I had the moves.
Everybody has the moves, so they say they have it, and you got the moves.
Everybody scored 4 touchdowns.
Nice. There you go. What high school did you graduate from?
I went to Forest Brook Senior High. The Big Blue will do it to you. Go Jaguars.
All right. Nicely done. Took 4 years there, and when you got into college, what did you want to study?
Well, I actually never went to college.
Okay.
I'm a self-taught musician. I'm not really a guy that reads music. So when I'm playing music, I really don't know what's coming next.
Okay.
It's kind of like, I guess, a basketball player when they're in the air. You ever hear with Michael Jordan, when they ask him, I don't know what my next move is going to be. I just create, you know.
So you're spontaneous.
Yeah, so when I'm playing my music, it's like I'm talking to you. You know, it's just like you're talking to me.
Right.
Now, if I went back and asked you, what exactly did you do with your vocal cords to make that? I don't know. It's just letting it flow.
Just letting it flow. That's the same thing with me, too, because I had the ear. Well, my teacher said I always had the ear for music, but I never really played an instrument. I love the keyboards myself. I love mallet percussion. That's one of my favorites. And I got started listening to smooth jazz back early 90s, when the 90s was just okay, you know. But I still resort back to the old jazz too. It's jazz is jazz to me, and there's no other genre I like playing better than that.
Yeah. The thing I like about jazz is the spontaneity itself. You know, it's all about proficiency. And you know, bluegrass is the same way. You know, bluegrass and jazz, it's all about proficiency on your instrument and knowing how to go beyond, you know, the notes and finding your voice within the notes.
Right.
So, you know, that's basically what I do. I don't really do a lot of covers, you know, because my opinion, I don't think a person can take a song, and I hear it a lot, oh man, you took that song and you made it yours. No, you didn't. The guy that created that song, that's his song. That's right. His stuff.
Exactly.
You know.
When you started this first CD, and this is all the songs, I guess, that on this first CD, The Means to Groove, What's Next, The Laid Back, The Junkyard Jam, all these songs, what was the purpose behind each of these songs? Another, we played the first two already. We played Means to a Groove and What's Next. How did you come up with the titles for these songs?
I don't come up with the title to the song until I listen to it a couple of times.
Okay.
And then the song tells me what to call it, if that makes any sense.
Well, that makes sense, yeah.
It says, you know, what's next? You know, it's like a hip thing. If you watch the video, I try to put some hip scenes in it.
That's right.
You know.
Yeah, because most of the stuff that we've aired here on the Jason Decanio Show has come from his YouTube channel, and then he has basically given it to me, and I have played it back here on the show many a times. I've played it on our Smooth Jazz show, a couple shows back, and I've even included it in an R&B show too, which was the last show before this show. So
music is music.
That's right. When you're in the studio and you're doing your thing and something sounds really good and it just, like you say, it just goes with the flow and everything, but do you get an idea or something in your head that could take you back to that particular, you know, form of...